50 million euros. That's what Count Gaspard de la Roche is worth on his return from America after a 30 years absence. 50 million euros. And then Gaspard dies. Accidentally. Or was he killed? Killed by whom? Was it his brother, Arthur, who needs the money to keep his mistresses? Or Georges, his chief steward, an old friend? Or did Lucie, his first love, want revenge for having abandoned her and for having come back with someone else? The accountant who'd mortgaged the chateau? Did Marie-Paul, his very young wife, really love him, or was it the money? Or the chateau's architect, Marie-Paul's lover, want her and his money all to himself? Or the diabolical Anna? And Gaspard's two daughters, always greedy for more? Anna, who thinks that anything goes in love, even the impossible. With Gaspard dead, Marie-Paul, the intruder, the fortune thief, must go. It's up to the commissioner and his assistant to find out the truth.
La nostra giustizia più discreta, più rapida e più radicale.
Allora non hai capito nulla, piccola stupida, niente! Senza di me saresti ancora con quel coglione di Gaspard! Chi ti ha dato la libertà, eh?
Ti permetto di dire questo.
Possiamo fare tutto per amore. Tutto. Anche l'impossibile.